There, there. Gods be damned. I've got to go wash off this blood. Eric is looking out the hall's windows onto the bay. A fleet of longships approach with sails of bold reds and blue. One banner I know well, Fognir, next for wall, king's ship, last we spoke. The other flag looks important. Yeah, important guests. See what I deal with all day long? Oh, things makes a little more sense. You hoped I would have a stake in saying everything's fine here when the royal guests arrived? Not me, the governor. Now I have to make sure there are not rotting bodies or pools of entrails still in the great hall before they come by. Can I ask one more favor? What is it? If you happened to stall our guests down on the docks, I wouldn't object. Maybe I will. Eric and Volgard hustle from the mead hall. To his credit, Eric tosses the barkeep a spar of silver for the mess. You give an apologetic shrug and go to greet the new arrivals down at the docks. So, da kommen die königlichen Herrschaften. Da wollen wir auch gleich mal hin. Wollte jetzt aber irgendwie mal nach meinen Helden gucken. Ich weiß gar nicht, wo das geht. Verdammt. Fognir. A familiar wall steps onto the docks. In your mind, you recall a much younger version tramping the halls of Crofheim, abundant in purpose. Gods, Albin, you're looking ancient. Comes with being old, and if there is Fognir, there must be Hakon. Must there? Still bleeding tribes from the poor and stupid old yorks. At what age do you lose a sense of shame? Jorunde demands it. I'll take that over lingering to death in Crofheim. Speaking of, I had no sense that you were so far from home. Just returned from Alberang, in fact. And glad for it. Hakon motions to the other ships in the bay, sails still fluttering. Golden wolf hat emblazoned on red, the king of men or someone on his behalf. The king's whelp. The king's son, Ladin, don't you know, Scrivener? We visit his capital, he visits ours. It's how you make alliances these days. It's a miserable waste of time. Yes, Hakon has it. I would almost forgotten. It's a good thing you're around, Hakon. Then you're going to Crofheim? I have the distinct feeling I finished my business in Strand and was heading there myself. We should caravan. We should give it a day, in better circumstances. I will drink a week away, but let's just be done. Find me tomorrow at the gates. What he's trying to say is the prince is a delight to behold. Where is Morgor? Hakon, have him find a place to put up the warriors. I'm heading up to meet the governor. A host of Gaien depart in his wake. You recognize a few others are strangers to you. Guess I'm off to find Morgor. See you in the morning, Scrivener. I'll be along. The young prince of men ambles from his ship. He brushes off his tunic, scanning the beach with low eyelids. Ludin looks for all the world the sort of boy who grew up pulling the legs from spiders. The long road back to Crofheim should be more interesting than most years, you think. Also, das Ganze geht nach Crofheim. Weariness suddenly settles in and you chuckle to yourself about what an odd day it has been. One of the governor's men at the Great Hall could find you a place to sleep. On the other hand, if you're going to join Vognir's caravan tomorrow, it might not hurt to share a drink with Hakon or to introduce yourself to the prince they spoke so highly of. Also, sie raten mir jetzt, entweder ich gehe da hoch und die besorgen mir einen Schlafplatz für den nächsten Tag, wo es dann weitergeht und wir eine Karawane bilden mit den angekommenen Riesen und dem Prinzen, also des Königssohn der Menschen. Und jetzt können wir entweder hingehen und ein bisschen einen heben oder den König ein bisschen kennenlernen und oder schon schlafen gehen. Wir gehen natürlich erstmal ein bisschen Met saufen. Scrivener. You find Hakon in a madhouse surrounded by other wall. Strand is no stranger to wall, but rarely sees this many. Hakon waves you over. Went straight for Flagon. Wagner is the one who agreed to pass up a drink. I wasn't invited to the governor's hall anyway. You already missed the massacre. Every year I make the rounds collecting taxes. Every year it's the human settlements that give me trouble. No surprise, what this time? When I got there, the great hall was already full of bodies. We added a few more. Ha, humans. I guess if I only lived as long as a ox fart, I might be dispatched to make something of myself, too. It's not too late to start drying, Haken. Haken let slip a low chuckle. Any wall could recount his deeds, known as he is for cutting a swath through dredge at Wagner's side in the Second War, and regularly since then. Okay, hier die Dredge, das sind also wieder die Gegner, diese Steindinger, die sie hier vertrieben hatten im großen Zweiten Krieg. Down here, I'm a glorified bodyguard. You might have a point. Just another reason to get back to Grofheim. Soon enough, I imagine. You drink until the meat house becomes overbearing, then step back into the cool air outside. Gut, da haben wir ein bisschen Chit-Chat gehabt mit unseren Kollegen Haken. Und dann treffen wir mal den Prinzen. Is this the right place? You find the prince at an inn. Guards blank the building, including a sharp-eyed wall who must be working for Ludin. A woman in a red eventually waves you over and stands nearby, arms crossed. Greetings, Prince Ludin. Yes, you're with Wagner, I don't remember. Not exactly, I've known Wagner a long time. I'll be joining you back to Grofheim with my guards. Ludin looks up for the first time. The woman doesn't react. Why? I work for the king, carrying tithes to the capital. We crossed by chance. Oh, a tax collector. Fine company. What do you want? Oh, just to introduce myself, I hope to learn more about you. I have a habit of recording history. I thought we may talk about your visit. Ach so. Urban hier ist so ein bisschen eine Art Schreiberling. Deswegen hat er auch immer diese Feder da drin, ne? Und er ist ein Steuereintreiber. Tja, möchte ich mir über ihn wissen, vorstellen. Ich nehme mal die drei. A wall historian? Haha, don't you already know? Your king and mine both have been practically trumpeting it throughout the cities. I've been on the road a while, I'm afraid. Ludin takes a deep sign. Whether tired or uncrazious, you aren't certain. Maybe both. A formality, mostly. Wagner came to our capital in Arbering, and now we got to the world's capital in Grofheim to cement this grand alliance for the next age of man and war. You sound unconvinced. There's no need for it, and it's damned cold up here. You get the sense he's struggling not to complain outright. You take the opportunity to excuse yourself. Also, der Menschenprinz sieht das Ganze nur als Farce an, das ist also totaler Unsinn. Gut, die Riesen hatten das eigentlich genauso. Dann gehen wir mal einen Ort suchen zum Schlafen. At dawn you're awoken by a delivery of goods. At least you think it's dawn. Damn, hard to tell with a sun that never moves. The governor's crest adorns the supplies leathers, or they're just promised to your mild surprise. You wonder if Eric had anything to do with that. 20 Rufpunkte. Your guards take the treasure wagon down to the gates. Wagner is already here. A while later, Ludin and his men appear groggy and disheveled. Mokra steps forward. Wagner's quartermaster, if you recall correctly, in charge of his unwieldy entourage of warriors. You know him only in passing. He asks if you're ready to be depart. Das Einzige, was wir machen können, we are ready. You follow Mokra and join the others. Usually, the smaller doors set into the gates would be enough to enter or leave the city, but the down guards have been told to push them open entirely. They mutter things under their breath that are best not heard. Perhaps the governor expected you to draw a crowd, but there's nothing of the sort. Just frustrated, tired people. It summarizes Strand well as a whole, you think. Ja. Der Governor ist davon ausgegangen, dass wir vielleicht verabschiedet werden. So, what the fuck? Von 35 sind wir jetzt bei 366 und Kämpfe haben wir 85. Wir haben 67 Tage lang Nahrungsmittel. Eine gute Moral. Da sehen wir die Tage verstreichen. Wir wandern. Ich kann nichts klicken. Oh, es ist schön gemacht. So, the caravan stops for the day. A gift, says Mokra, cracking up mad casks. From our gracious friend, the governor of Strand. How was passed with righteous laughter as the mat is passed throughout camp. Drink a little, drink a lot, oder toast to Woknir. I'm toasting to Woknir. You raise your drink, toasting the alliance between man and wall. The other join in. Ludin's expression is like a stone wall, but the other laugh at your exaggerations. Eventually you sit down beside Woknir. Jetzt können wir mit Woknir ein bisschen chit-chatten, noch mehr trinken oder einfach weiter saufen gehen. Drinky, drink merrily. Ich weiß jetzt nicht genau, was damit der Unterschied ist zu dem da. Aber ich möchte sowieso ein bisschen chat with Woknir. Thanks for the speech, slurs Woknir. Top. Looks like you didn't have to miss out after all. Thanks to Mokra, I thought the damned governor would never shut up. Did he give you the history of his entire family? He tried, then he asked me to clean up his mess. For your benefit, turns out. I would have given the job to you too. Gods, there's no joy in politics. Speaking of what happens after this business with Ludin. Hopefully the boy goes back to Aberring on his own. And I can take out some frustrating on Dredge or something. Starting to sound like Haken. You don't like the life of diplomat? Haha, don't you miss the fight, Urban? You down your mat instead of replying. Woknir slouches and shakes his head. There's no great joy in killing Dredge. But this, I'm pretty sure this nonsense is some scheme between the two kings to force some kind of lineage. Used to be, warriors would follow you for what you've done. Isn't that why they follow you now? Is it, or is it because I'm the next in line? These lines are getting muddy, old wall. They've always been muddy, Woknir. Woknir stares into the campfire, lost in thoughts. You leave him to it. You rise groggily at the campsite, a casualty of merriment. Woknir's already kicking warriors awake when you spot Ludin stalking your direction. He sidesteps sleeping bodies. Better wake up, you notch Woknir. You're needed. Ah, it's Ludin. Always a pleasure. You look well rested. Woknir releases a caged yawn. A caged yawn. And received a hard-eyed stare in return. How long to Crofham? Ha! We are only 2 days out of Strand, you know. Come, I will show you on a map. World map. Click and drag the map to look around. A portrait icon shows where your caravan is in the world. You can also click on any location to get some history about it. When you're done with the map, click the X at the bottom of the screen. Ah, okay, das hier ist also die... Das ist alles? Ah, nein. Ach, Herr Jemine. Die Weltkarte ist ja riesig. Und überall kriegt man Informationen. Klettberg, a straightforward name for what is essentially a rock of ice floating listlessly out in the waste. As far as anyone knows, no man, wall, dredge or animal has lived here. It seems likely none ever will. Warden, there's something deeply unsettling about the island at the top of the world called Warden, and those who have dared to travel here say they left almost immediately, not because of something they discovered, but for the unearthly sounds they did not wish to discover the source of. Was ist das? The constellations. While the constellations at one time represented not only the gods, but a way to navigate the seas at night, since the gods have died, the stars from nothing but random faint patterns. Transportation. Where longship and horse once ruled travel, eventually the waterways became mapped out, the horses were eradicated by horseborn, cities became landlocked, and man and wall became more accustomed to walking great distance with great pack animals called yorks, or never leaving their homes at all. Alter, da gibt's so viel zu lesen. Aber, ach du heilige Scheiße. Ich glaube, da bin ich morgen noch nicht fertig mit dem Lesen. Das meine ich nicht böse. Ich glaube aber, das wäre eine leichte... Ja. Ich glaube, das möchtet ihr lieber alles selber erfahren. Da ist also unsere Karawane. Da ist Strand. As close as anything comes to a bastion of racial tolerance, both man and wall compete to scratch out a living in this, the biggest trade city along the west coast. Many people still believe the god Dangler still watches over it, granting good fortune. Gut, also genau da sind wir. Karlsfjord sind wir gerade rüber getippert. The fjord splitting off into wall territory was named after Karl, the only wall to ever become governor of Strand. Albeit for only a short time before the title returned to the human families whose ancestors originally built the city. Und wir sind hier gleich beim Last Gate, the crossing of the small bridge leading from Fedrevel onto the wandering road marked a small but significant moment in which the war truly separated itself from humanity in search of their own lands. Ja, und was ist Fedrevel? Fedrevel Badweathers. The glades that blow in from the bay and around the mountain peaks keep Vedra in a generally unpleasant state. What really cemented the name was the kind of person who would live there, man cast out from Strand for one reason or another with nowhere else to go. Na okay, also das ist jetzt erstmal die Karte.